It's one of the more annoying interview questions. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Who even knows what they're having for dinner later that day, let alone where your life is going to be in half a decade? Luckily, there's no right answer, but here are a few pointers to impress them. To view this video, please enable JavaScript, and consider upgrading to a web browser that supports HTML5 video. I'd love to be your best employee ever, diligently working hard every day and never making any mistakes. In the same way that, I'm too much of a perfectionist, is a rubbish and predictable answer to the question about your biggest flaws, this answer will make you forgettable to the employer. While you want to have positive goals, don't use a cookie-cutter answer and actually think about what you want. Don't try to steal their job or waste their time. There's such a thing as being too ambitious in a job interview. The interviewer needs to know you're not trying to A. steal their job or B. progress so quickly that you never commit to the job you've applied to. They're hiring you to do the job in question, so although a desire to progress within the company is looked for, you need to make clear you're not looking to jump ship to a different department or higher up job as soon as the opportunity arises. Be realistic, 5 years isn't that long, so saying you want to be CEO in an interview for a sales assistant looks sloppy. Research similar career paths and see how other people have progressed in that time frame and mirror them slightly. A good example of this is mastering a work-related skill, or moving a rung or two up the ladder. Have a goal rather than just general growth in mind. You don't need to be super upwardly mobile, instead you can offer something else like hitting certain targets. Putting a number or tangible goal in your answer shows you've really thought through what you want to bring to their company. You might say you want to increase sales by X% or complete a certain training program offered to you at work. If needs must lie, perhaps you only applied for this job for the paycheck or as a stopgap while studying. Your interviewer really doesn't need to know any of that, and if that means you're lying with your answer, then so be it. Of course, a caveat of this: if you're going to leave early on or genuinely hate the job and work poorly, then, perhaps simply reconsider whether it's the right position for you. Example answers: I'd like to have completed the training program offered by your company and be on track to becoming management. I've been researching the course online and I'm excited to get so much industry experience. Ideally, it'd be great to carve out a niche for myself in insert field. I feel with my previous experience and passion for insert field, I could grow great relationships with your clients and become a go-to trusted source for them. One of my biggest motivators are targets, so in this role I'd love to be able to increase sales by X% within 5 years. I'm not sure I have an exact position or goal in mind, but it's important to me to feel challenged and push myself at work. I think this job can really offer me that, so in 5 years I'd simply want to be continuously developing and growing. At the moment I'm currently study XYZ. In 5 years' time I'll have these qualifications, and want to bring them to this role as much as possible, perhaps even training others in this if that would help other employees grow. I noticed online that you have clients overseas, so if I got the role I'd like to undertake language classes. This would help me develop professionally and be equipped to take on new and exciting projects abroad if there was scope for that. This company has a lot of inspirational people. I'd like to follow their lead and learn from them in the business, and hopefully in 5 years could be on a similar career path. More, the basics of impressing a woman on a first date. More, 8 ways employers can put candidates off going for a job.